to YouTube video number 2. So we are now 2 weeks from the last video, like when it's recorded. So 2 weeks ahead, we've now got a pool session today. So I'm going to be, as usual, taking you through all the exercises, the exercise order, tips, cues, giving you some education and some entertainment at the same time. We've got the stiff leg deadlift today, so one of my big hitters for the week. I get quite nervous for this lift, but need to make sure that I'm either retaining this or progressing, especially throughout this diet. If you want to make it a big thing, I'm just progressing my movements and not letting that performance drop off. I've got some of the powerlifting boys in with me today, so I'm going to feel like a small child. Sean pulls 600 pounds, 272.5 kg. Chrissy is just absolutely fucking massive, and he's also been able to pull a lot more than me, so I'm going to be the smallest out of all the deadlifters, but we'll get some compilation of a wee deadlift. Then we will be posing upstairs at the end of the session. I'll give you guys a pep update as well. Update on my foods, where I'm at, what Finn and I both think of the position that I'm in. But yeah, let's just have a good session, take you all through it. Let's fucking do it. Just do a little bit of maybe some metamorphosis. Boom, 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 boom. I think we should all give a well done to Chrissy and Sean for their successful singles. I'm just saying comment well done for you, since I'm a nice human being. Right now I've got my back off. I took 150 for 10 last week. I'm going to go for, 150 for 12. My rep range is 10 to 12. So I'm going to go for 155 and try to get that within the rep range. Or I will get it within the rep range. The top set was all right. It was nothing brilliant. It wasn't shit. It was just kind of in the middle. Same match reps as last week. Wasn't quite as tidy. Struggled to brace quite a lot. So yeah, it's still maintained. And I'll make sure I maintain that for next week or improve it. So yeah, just need to make sure this back off progresses now.
Let's go, Josh.
Gonna double chalk up again. Sorry, I shall return. Really need a pee. Sorry guys, I'll be back. Nah. 9. Up 5, down 3. Unreal. Mate, it was like, as soon as the beat dropped, I was ready to put on that. Oh fuck. So now I'm gonna shit myself with a fucking brace here. Are you recording that?
Yeah. Let's take him back. Coming up, I was confused. My mommy kissing a girl. Confusion occurs coming up in the cold world. Daddy ain't around, probably up.
So, upper back row. You want to focus on moving your scapula instead of simply just extending and then pulling your arms back. What I mean by moving your scapula, so your shoulder blade here, letting it kind of warp around your chest as you come down, and then think about retracting, pulling that back as much as you can. So retracting your scapula here, and then really pulling that back. It's where your upper back musculature pretty much inserts. So to take it through its full range of motion, through its full contractile range, you want to make sure that that scapula moves forward, so like this. Making sure that those shoulder blades come forward and pulling them back, instead of simply just extending the arms and pulling them back like that. So, you want to get a big upper back? Start doing that. Kill a nigga on my shoulder, really do it. That's the true meaning of a ghost rider. 10 G's to take your daughter out of air forces. Believe you me, homie, I know all about losses. I'm from Compton, where the wrong colors, be cautious. One phone call, I had your body dumped in Marcy. I stay strapped like car seats. Been banging since my little nigga Rob got killed for his Barclays. That's 10 years, I told Pooh in 95. I'll kill you if you try me for my Air Max 95s. Told Banks when I met him, I'ma ride. And if I gotta die, rather homicide. I ain't had 50 cent with my grandmama.
or die. Now I'm going back to Cali with my Jacob on. See how time fly.
With the underdogs on top, and I'm gonna shine, homie, until my heart stop.
Go ahead, envy me. I'm Raps MVP, and I ain't going nowhere, so you can get to know me.
Beat of the love with the underdogs on top, and I'm gonna shine, homie, until my heart stop.
Go ahead, envy me. I'm Raps MVP, and I ain't going nowhere, so you can get to know me.
From the beginning to the end, lose is lose, win is win, this is real win. Got to pretend the cold world of the
air. This didn't go very well. Are you recording? Yeah. Feathers were all right. The back offset, I was a bit rushed. I don't know, I think it may have just been because it was a load increase subconsciously. Not scared of it, like I wasn't going into the set thinking, oh fuck. But I think I might have rushed things just a little bit. So next week, I'll make sure that's a little bit more controlled. With deadlifts, when you control it more, it's not as if it's going to take away loads. You'll have more ability to brace. It won't be as bouncy off the floor, so you don't need to pretty much catch it and get all that load through your back. So you usually actually get more reps when you control it better. I was just an idiot and didn't control it very well. So I'll be taking 155 for 10 plus next week, make sure that goes well. But the rest of the session, make sure to make it positive. So that's the second exercise. Right, so fourth exercise, I think, pull-ups. Again, another upper back bias movement. So focusing on letting my shoulders kind of raise up, not while like caving my chest, keeping that nice and puffed up, but letting my shoulders move to lengthen it out and pulling them back and down. Making sure that I actually get the range of motion as well. It's not like pull up and come like halfway down and like half rep it. Get that full range of motion, control it, and fully contract there. Took 7.5 kg. For 7 last week, 7.5 kg for 8 this week, so another progression. That's lat pull downs progressed, stiff legs matched, then the back offset debatable, low row progressed, and this progressed as well, so fucking brilliant, brilliant. You're the alpha, yeah. Right, so fifth exercise or so, I think I'm going to stop saying what exercise it is because I keep forgetting. We've got the single arm lat bias row here, so a lot of the lat work that I have is single arm, so it means that I can offset myself to the side, tuck that working side shoulder down, lean over and really drive that elbow in. If I was to do this dual arm, it's going to be quite hard. Let's just imagine the chest pad is out. It's going to be quite hard to keep those elbows in. They're pretty naturally just going to come to like here. Whereas again, with a single arm, drop that shoulder, elbow drives in, much better contraction with my lats. Like, there's literally no weight on that right now, and I can feel my lat really contracting there. So if you're not doing your lat work unilateral already, I would advise you do so. Another thing with your lat work is making sure that you're thinking to drive your elbow down. If you mindlessly just pull back the way, you're not going to get a great internal feel. So think about driving the elbow down, like dragging it down. Don't think about pulling with your arm. Think about pulling with that elbow and bringing it down the way, scraping it off the floor and contracting when you get here. Don't pull behind your body because it's kind of out with your lats range of motion. It's just going to, again, promote that shoulder moving and then a little bit going into your upper back. Pull along down until you get in line with your torso and then call it there. You hear that? That's a good thing to fucking get you up for the set, innit? It should be my last exercise after the rear delt flies, but both the machines are being taken. So this first Again, with the abs, their function is to flex the spine, so to really crunch down on it, so that's what you're thinking of doing. This machine is brutally heavy, very, very heavy. My top set will be 10 kg. By my last set of 15 to 20, I'll literally have nothing on it. It's brutal. But yeah, abs, what, 3-4 times throughout the week now. I need to make sure that they're not shit when I go on stage. Obviously, dieting reveals your abs, but you need to have decent abs there to actually reveal. So they work like any other muscle group. Progressively overload them, train them hard, and they'll grow. They'll look better when you do dieting. Composure. Right, so final exercise, got the rear delt fly here. Doing this on like a pec deck machine, so like a reverse pec deck as some people would call it. May not be optimal for the alignment of the rear delts, but there's a lot of stability. I get a good connection with my rear delts, and it's not bad. Like, I could do a single arm rear delt cable fly, but with this, your rear delts do run at a kind of 45 to 60 degree angle. So literally, instead of just being completely upright, I'll just put my hips back so that when I do come out here, it's as if I'm kind of, say, pulling down a wee bit instead of being completely up, if you're to think about it. So instead of being upright, I'd be more like that. So I'm not running completely along like that. Just put your hips back a little bit and you'll be good. So final exercise, 3 sets of this, then we'll do some posing stuff. You ready? Man spreading? Can't not do that. Right, so pull done. Not a bad session. I didn't progress again on my stiff leg deadlifts, but it is what it is. Match them. Make sure next week I'll progress that. But posing, I hope you all enjoyed that as well. At a pretty good spot just now. We're kind of ahead of the game in terms of body weight for where we want to be in prep. We're pretty much on track. But the visual look itself, like, I'm looking a bit leaner than we suspected. So next week I've got a deload. Simply, my split is pretty much just a variation of a push-pull legs, rest, upper, lower, rest. So for next week I'll just be taking the upper, lower session off. So it's pretty much 4 days in a row where I'll be resting. Through that time, I'll be having a diet break most likely as well. Again, because we are a little bit ahead. So I'll be having more food, possibly an off-plan meal. We'll see what Finn says. But yeah, pretty much on track at the moment. I'll get Evan to put up my macros and stuff. Pretty much on training days, 3,000 calories. Non-training day, 2,350 or so. Then 25 minutes of cardio every morning. So first thing in the morning, get up, walk, cardio, then eat, get on with my day from there. So 25 minutes every morning from there. Then steps, 11,000. So nothing too bad, literally 3 walks a day. So yeah, everything's pretty good at the moment. 6 weeks, nearly 6 weeks deep into prep, 17 weeks out to the first show, 25 weeks to the final one. So yeah, on track. But hope you enjoyed the video. Remember to say it this time, like and subscribe. Make sure you do that. But yeah, thank you guys. And I shall see you in the next one. Yeah!